In this Q&A video, we're going to answer the question, can I use a BSEN 60309 socket outlet to charge my EV? This question relates to a few videos we've made on the subject of the Proxima range of industrial sockets from SCARMI, so please go and check those out after watching this video. So what's prompted this question? In short, LinkedIn. A while back, someone created a post suggesting a life hack that could save you tons of money by installing a BSEN 60309 socket outlet to use as an EV charge point. Now, this is not about battering the guy who posted it. He genuinely thought he'd found a loophole and just wanted to share it with others. Having said that, I don't go on social media and give out advice about property investment, so maybe there's something in that. Anyway, it generated a lot of feedback, some of which made some fairly massive assumptions about the earthing arrangements of the supply, the protective devices, and where the socket was located, all of which would need addressing if you were doing the install. And actually, I think the post has been deleted since all my search skills are not what they need to be, but it is a good question. Can we just use one of these as a dedicated EV charge point? The answer, unsurprisingly, is it depends. Let's turn to section 722 of BS7671, which covers EV installations. We find the guidance for the connecting outlet in regulation 722.55.101.0.201.1, which is a bit of a mouthful. It reads, each AC charging point shall incorporate one socket outlet complying with BS1363-2 marked EV on its rear, and except where there is no possibility of confusion, a label shall be provided on the front face or adjacent to the socket outlet or its enclosure stating suitable for electric vehicle charging, or two, one socket outlet or connector complying with BSEN 60309-2, which is interlocked and classified to clause 6.1.5 of BSEN 60309-1 to prevent the socket contact being live when accessible, or three, one socket outlet or connector complying with BSEN 60309-2, which is part of an interlocked self-contained product complying with BSEN 60309-4 and classified to clauses 6.1.101 and 6.1.102 to prevent the socket contact being live when accessible. And we're going to stop reading that there, as the rest of the options relate to dedicated EV charge points. So we can use a special EV 1362 square pin socket outlet to charge up an EV, although it's the most painfully slow option of all. Or there's options 2 and 3 there, socket outlets complying with BSEN 60309-2, so it seems that these are acceptable. Now, there may be a few very well-informed people watching this, even now limbering up their typing fingers to point out regulation 553.1.201, which states, every socket outlet for household and similar use shall be of the shuttered type, and for an AC installation shall preferably be of a type complying with BS1363. So it seems that the socket outlet complying with BSEN 60309 cannot in fact be installed in a domestic setting because it doesn't have that shuttering. However, let's look at the statement at the beginning of part 7, which contains general information for this section. It states, the particular requirements for each section, special installation or location, in part 7 supplement or modify the general requirements contained in other parts of BS7671. So we're back to it being okay, because the general requirement for a socket outlet in a domestic setting is modified in this case. Or is it? Reading on, the absence of reference to the exclusion of a part, a chapter, a section, or a regulation means that the corresponding general regulations are applicable. So because the regulation on EV charge point connectors doesn't specifically exclude regulation 553.1.201, then it must be applicable, so a BSEN 60309 socket outlet isn't acceptable. Gag! Which is it? Well, in the absence of any explicitly stated information on this subject, we at eFIXX look at it this way. It's one of those times to look at the intent behind a regulation. Regulation 553.1.201 says we can't use sockets in domestic installations that aren't shuttered. Why? Well, it's to stop people who don't know any better from sticking knitting needles or scissors into socket outlets and receiving a potentially fatal shock. The shutter prevents the live terminals from being accessed until a plug is connected to the socket. So with that intent in mind, and bearing in mind that the regulations in Part 7 modify the regs for particular settings or installations, it does allow for BSEN 60309 outlets to be installed. You could take this to mean only on non-domestic installations, or you could look at regulation 722.55.101.0.201.1 again and notice that it states the BSEN 60309 socket outlets must be interlocked. Why? To prevent the contact being live when accessible. So is it fair to say that the spirit of Regulation 553.1.201 has been met with interlocks instead of shutters? What do you think? Would you be happy to install a BSEN 60309 interlocked socket outlet on a domestic property for a dedicated EV charge point? Or do you think it would be non-compliant? Do you think it's a viable option, bearing in mind you may well need to also provide pen fault protection and either a type B RCD or a type A or FRCD with a residual direct current detecting device? Let us know what you think. So you can use a BSEN 60309 socket outlet as an EV charge point, although it's a bit of a grey area in domestic settings and some judgment will be needed. If you found this video helpful, then please check out these videos here, and thank you very much for watching.